Hey guys, my name is Victoria Islas and I am the web designer and online marketer at Creative 2. And today we're going to talk about four ways you can improve your website today. Let's get into it. So here is your first step. Make it super easy for your visitors, who are essentially your potential clients or your future clients. Make it easy for them to find what they're looking for on your website. So if I land on your website, and I'm gonna give you an example, say your restaurant, I'm looking for your menu, right? Make it easy for me to find your menu on your website. So how do you know what your clients or potential clients or even your current clients, how do you know what they're looking for when they go on your website? So here are two tips for that. It could simply be when they come into your business, what are the most frequently asked questions that they ask you when they come in? That could be a good indicator of what they're looking for on your website. They're basically looking for basic things like your phone number, your address, and pricing. So if you're a restaurant, maybe they're looking for pricing on a menu item, right? Or if maybe you are a doctor, maybe they're looking for things such as your address or even your phone number so they can make an appointment. If I could tell you one thing, is to think like your visitor. So here's a second thing to consider so that you can create a great online website experience for your visitors. Have real photography of your business or your services or your products, okay? Have real photography. I've seen businesses go on Google, find stock photography, or even buy stock images from, you know, Getty Images or some website like that. So in other words, guys, don't cheap out on photography. Hire someone to do really nice, a nice photo shoot, really nice photographs of your business. Hire someone today so that you can, that way you can start to create that nice branding experience online. All right, guys, so here's the third thing that I'm going to tell you, and it's pretty simple. If you have a goal to tackle online, okay, we all have online goals, and if you don't, you better start writing them down. But as a business, you have to have goals online. So one of the best ways that you can improve your website is by placing what we call, what we web designers call, call to action. Call to action. All right, so what is this? So when someone lands on your website, you kind of have to guide them to do what you want them to do. If your goal is, okay, I want more online orders, then you might want to have a call to action right on the homepage, which is the very first page that they land on, that leads them to the online ordering system that you have implemented. Another example would be, okay, if you want more people to come into your gym, say you're a CrossFit gym, or you're just a, you know, a typical conventional gym, you want more people to come through, then have a call to action for that. Let them know, hey, come try a free class. Click here now. And it will lead them to the form, or it would lead them to where you want them to, what you'd want them to do, right? So if you want a phone call, then it would lead them to a phone call. So those are things to consider when you're building your website, if you already have a website, or if you're going to find someone to build a website for you. Make sure that you think about your online goals. What are some things you want people to do when they visit your website, and set up those call to actions. And by the way, they can be all over your website. That's totally cool. And here's the fourth and last thing I'm gonna share with you on how to improve your website today. All right, this was real simple, guys, but I think as business owners, we get really, really like busy, obviously. Okay, we get busy with accounting, we get busy with dealing with customers and our services and our products, whatever it is for you. We get busy, I get it, but you have to make time to go check on your website every month. At the end of the month, just schedule in a couple of minutes to go online and check on your website. Does it need updates? Is it broken? Okay, because if it's broken, guess what's gonna happen? Your bounce rate is going to be off the yin-yang, okay? So what's a bounce rate? A bounce rate is how many visitors left your website like instantly, right? So if that bounce rate is super high, then you know there's a problem on your website. And here's a tip, make sure you have Google Analytics installed on your website. If you don't, make sure you talk to your web developer, or if you're getting a new website, just make sure that it's in the website package. You wanna make sure you have Google Analytics installed, just so that you can, you know, those are indicators that there's something wrong with your website. You can also install Webmaster Tools by Google. These things are completely free, okay, guys? So if you want it, even if you have technical skills, you can go sign up for this and install it to your website. It's a piece of code, you put it into your website, and it helps you keep your website running smoothly, okay? So again, make sure you go check on your website, make sure it's not broken, make sure that it's updated with the latest information. So if you moved recently, make sure your address is updated. If you changed your number, make sure your number is up to date. You don't want to miss any customers or any clients or any potential business, right? That's what your business website is out there to do. So anyways, I hope you found this useful. My name is Victoria Isis from Creative 2, and we build websites and we do online marketing. So if you're looking for someone locally in Yuma, go ahead and give us a call and we'll get back to you. Thank you guys for watching. Until next time.